And these are today's shoutouts. If you want to see yourself in the next video, then subscribe and leave a comment. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Arca here, and I'd like to ask you a favor. If you find this video useful, please do make sure to subscribe to my channel. Help me grow, and I'm starting to gift subscribers. More info at the end of the video. Please enjoy. What is up, boys? Arca here, back again with a brand new video where I'll tell you everything you need to know about the new DirectX 12 and DLSS update. These two new features will both skyrocket everyone's FPS. So if you could get like 60 frames previously on Fortnite on your PC, be prepared because you will be literally pulling 200 now. The news are massive, and the requirements to run the game at a playable FPS have just been slashed in two. So before we jump right in, I'll tell you everything you need to know to set up and get those 200 plus frames. I'd like to say a quick word about the 3k subs goal and how grateful I am, boys. It's been a long 4 months since I started recording these type of videos. And back then I had 30 subs, I didn't record on the channel at all. And I thought that hey, if I record some Fortnite tips and tricks videos, that'll be fun. But I never thought I'd be looking at 3k subs in such a short amount of time. So boys, if you haven't yet subscribed but are interested in videos that help you improve and be up to date with the game, then don't hesitate to drop that sub button down below with the notification bell turned on not to miss any of my new videos. But yeah, without further ado, let's jump right in. So this video will go over two different features, how they work and why they can increase your FPS if set up correctly. So to start off, DirectX 12 is a major improvement from the DirectX 11 we used before. And this feature will also be available only on computers and more specifically Windows-based operating systems. So no Macs or consoles, sorry guys. And unfortunately, with how DirectX 12 is developed, it's only able to run on Windows. And it's also a Microsoft-owned company, and Microsoft makes Windows. So yeah, I think you get the idea why they made it like that. Microsoft just wants to keep the tech to its own Windows platform and nobody else. But the cool thing is, in nearly all games, when you have the option to turn on DirectX 12, your frames drop a lot. And that is because DirectX 12 unlocks some better graphical features, like ray tracing, and when you have them on, your FPS just plummets. But Epic implemented it really differently into Fortnite. Like, I was amazed when I first found out about it. But DirectX 12, which usually always makes your FPS slower, actually increased it by 2 times for a lot of people. So if you were running with 100 frames, you could literally pull 200 now. There were tons of videos on the internet about it, and that got me thinking about all these new changes with also addition of DLSS. And I thought that DLSS increases your FPS, DirectX 12 increases your FPS too. So if you use them both, you can get a really cheap PC build and play at a really nice frame rate. Or you could literally boost your current setup to frames you never dreamed of. Like I saw on YouTube peeps running around with 400 FPS, and that is insane. But back to the topic and why DirectX 12 increases your FPS in-game. That is because they wrote a statement that specifically said this update will ensure a more stable performance and you won't get any dips in firefights and sweaty build-offs. And the problem before was that DirectX 11 used only 2 cores of your CPU to run the game, and any other cores would just work a little bit to support some minor details. So your performance of the game was heavily relied on the first 2 cores of your CPU. And if you had like an i5, which specialized in less but more powerful cores, you had more FPS than let's say peeps running with an i9 that had like 12 cores. Because they were all clocked at slower speeds. So the i5 was the machine to have and get that momentum going. But now with DirectX 12 update, it actually removes all the pressure of your 2 first cores and evens it all out on all of them. Like on the screenshot you see on the top is the game running on DirectX 11 and you see how loaded is the first thread. It's running all of the base components of the game, but the graph below is showing how the game will run in DirectX 12 with a more evened out core usage.
So yeah, that is pretty cool, because with this new update, which hopefully other games will start using too, can finally use all of our cores on the CPU to play. And I know there are a lot of people, including myself, who have a lot of cores they will finally be able to use. Like, I have an i7-8086K, and it's like a 40-year anniversary processor Intel did for a limited time. But they have 6 cores and 12 threads. And yeah, 12 threads is massive. And me being able to finally use them in the game will mean my CPU is actually working now. Because before this, the only time I used all of my cores on the CPU was when I was rendering videos for you guys. Which, by the way, if you didn't know, takes a lot of total time, like a whole day to make one. Because I come up with the idea, write a script, read it, gather some gameplay, and then render it all together. So if you wish to support the grind and also find the videos like these useful, then don't hesitate to hit that subscribe button down below and join the under 3k squad. But yeah, enough plugging, boys, back to the CPU. And yeah, from personal experience, I saw like a 50 FPS increase. And mind you, I was already running the game at a solid 200 FPS. So getting 250 is pretty insane, because at that level, you are basically capped by your CPU if you haven't gotten like a $600 i9. But hey, my i7 from 2018 pulling all those frames amazed me, and I think you should try to as well, to see if you can get a solid 100 FPS boost as well. But onto DLSS, and this is the feature that was once dropped with the DirectX 12 and ray tracing at once. And I'm not gonna talk about ray tracing because it's pretty useless for an FPS guide video, because it's like an FPS killer. But DLSS is something that is always added with ray tracing, if it's ever added to any game. And it's basically this new anti-aliasing tag that's been made by Nvidia to ship with ray tracing and just boost your FPS by 50, if not more. So if you're running the game at 50 frames and turn on DLSS, you'll see a solid 90 FPS. And Nvidia made DLSS to specifically ship with ray tracing, because it's such an FPS killer, you just need a boost to return the FPS you lost. And DLSS is that. Or otherwise, nobody would accept the fact that you would have to lose 100 frames if you want better shadows from ray tracing. But yeah, turn on DLSS and DirectX 12, and you should see an FPS boost of around 150, maybe 10 plus minus depending on your system. And that's from the 40 to 50 FPS boost you'll get from DLSS, and also 100 frames increase from DirectX 12. And also, because of these two new features, I think the requirements to run the game at a playable frame rate dropped significantly. Like before, you could build a PC that would run Fortnite at 20 frames. And I'm sure that right now, it would easily pull 60 to 90 FPS. I will check it out and make sure that this can actually happen now. And if it is true, then I will make a video for a new PC build, which will allow you to run the game at a solid 200 frames. So yeah, like a specific build for high refresh rate monitors coming up really soon. But if you enjoyed this video and found it useful, then hit that subscribe button down below to join under the 3K squad. And don't forget to hit the notification bell also, not to miss any of my new videos. I cover topics that help you improve at the game by giving you tips on the best metas, builds, and just general updates at the game and the esports scene. So yeah, if you think this sounds interesting, then hit the button down below. It's free real estate. This is it for this video, guys. I hope I'll see you in the next one. And as always, peace. What is up, boys? Just a quick message. Basically, I have a Twitch and I have a YouTube account also. And I'm not sure where I should be streaming for you guys. So where do you prefer to watch Fortnite streams? Is it like on YouTube or Twitch? Because YouTube is my main platform by far. On Twitch, I haven't even streamed once on that account before. Of course, I know how to stream. It's like, I'm not a noob. Come on, guys. But yeah, which one do you prefer? That's what I want to know. So yeah, leave your opinion in the comments. I will try and read them. And yeah, guys, see you in the next one. Hey, guys, this is the end of the video. I hope you enjoy and find it useful. If you want to join my future Battle Pass and V-Box giveaways, do make sure to easily apply by subscribing and leaving a comment with your Fortnite username. I will be choosing 5 random people in the near future for weekly gifts. Peace.